Hey guys, this is Rosa Kelly. Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm here to talk about my favorite books of 2022. Welcome back to the channel. I hope that you guys are doing well. So like I said, today I want to talk about the books and that were my favorite reads for 2022. So on 2022, I read a total of 102 books, which is crazy. I had the goal of reading 90 books, and I think I reached that goal by October, and I'm just excited. I have so many recommendations for you guys. So before we start with the list, I do wanna say that these are the books that I most enjoy on 2022. They are not necessarily books that came out on 2022, although some of these are. I do have some honorable mentions, books that didn't quite make it to my top 10, but I enjoy them just so much. And I just enjoy so many books in general. I'll probably do a separate video just talking about my favorite thrillers, because most of the books that I read were thrillers and they're just all so good. Let's talk about the books that I enjoy so much, but they didn't quite make it to my top 10. However, I just love these books probably just as much. It's just really hard to narrow down your books to 10 when you love so many. So the first one is going to be And Then There Were None by the Queen Agatha Christie. And this book is the mother of all mysteries, and I could not, of course, solve the mystery, and I just can't believe that I had been missing out on Agatha Christie, because this was the first one that I read and just absolutely loved it. I also read The Murder on the Orient Express, which I like probably just as much, and I can't wait to read more of Agatha Christie. And so the next book that I'm going to mention is Dracula by Bram Stoker, and I just, again, can't believe I never read this before. I did like how the book was told in terms of like diaries and interviews, and I thought it was really interesting to actually get to know the story of the original. The only thing that I didn't quite enjoy was like the book was a little bit slow, and so it took me a little bit of time to get through it, but I did enjoy it so much. Another books, and these are actually two books that didn't make it to my list, but books that I highly recommend, is Mouse, and this is by Art Spiegelman. And so I read volumes 1 and 2, and this is a graphic novel about World War II. And so basically Azon, he is a comic, so he draws comics, and he decided to interview his dad about his experience on concentration camps, and also to try to understand his father's behavior a little bit. And he decides to document all of that, all of those conversations, and put them into this graphic novel. So there's volumes 1 and 2, and just, it was just such a quick read, packed with so much information, and I just thought it was fantastic the way that it was told. The next book on this list is The Hacienda by Isabel Cañas, and this book just gave me all those gothic vibes. And the book is described as a combination of Mexican Gothic and Rebecca, and I read Mexican Gothic and I absolutely loved it. I am yet to read Rebecca, so that's definitely a book that I am going to be picking up next. And I just thought this was fantastic. I love how the town was described, the house was described. I imagine this era of Mexico City and this hacienda, and just really transport me to those times. And the last book on this list is A Flicker in the Dark, and this is by Stacey Willingham. And this book for me was probably the most intriguing. It just, again, gave me all of those spooky vibes, trying to figure out who did what, and just really enjoyed this book from beginning to end. So I highly, highly recommend that book as well. Okay, so now let's get to the books that made it to my top 10. Now, I do want to say that all these books are probably equally my favorite, although I am putting them on some order. I just enjoy all of them. And the first one is actually a book that I don't have physically, but I'm going to put it here on the screen, and that is The Woman They Could Not Silence by Kate Moore. And that is a book that I read at the beginning of 2022, and is still with me now. Like, it's been a year and I'm still thinking about that book. And it was just absolutely magnificent. It was full of information. It was full of detail about how times really were. And so this book is actually based on true events, and we're following this woman who was put on an asylum because she just basically didn't agree with her husband and he didn't like her opinions. So she was put into this sanatorium, and basically he claimed that she was crazy, and she kind of lost access to her children, and she would just fight so hard to prove that she was not insane, that she just had her own opinions. And there were so many cases in where she just simply had to comply and do what he wanted, that way he would take her out of the sanatorium, but she just refused to basically let her voice not be heard. And it was just such a beautiful example of strength and womanhood, and just highly recommend that book. And so the next book is A Diary of Blood, and this book is by Esty Gibson. So this book was just the most poetic book that I have read. I absolutely love the story. So we're following Constanza, who is the first wife of Dracula, and she was saved by Dracula, and she had this infatuation with him. She completely adored him and protected him and just kind of had him on this pedestal. And then by being with him for hundreds of years, she kind of learn what his true nature was, how he was manipulating her and using her, and she decided to take revenge. And you see her going through hundreds of years to kind of figure out a way to get rid of him. But I think what I loved the most about this book was the descriptions, the way, again, that is told, the way that was told, that was so poetic and so beautiful, so lyrical, and just so many beautiful quotes. So the next book in my list is Malibu Rising, and this is by Taylor Jenkins Reid. And this book was just so beautiful. I think it made me cry so many times. But on this book, we are following the story of these siblings who basically are just everything for each other. So on this book, we're following the story of this woman who is in love. She falls in love with this, I think they know each other from high school, but he became this very famous actor, and she was just always in and out, basically doing whatever he wanted, and he constantly cheated on her, and so he was just not, you know, not the best. And I kind of hated him a lot. But then she, the woman, continued to try to make it work and whatnot. So it comes to a point where she just basically stopped functioning as a mother, and the older sibling kind of took care of all of her siblings. And you can see how they're so united, all the things that she does for them, at the same time trying to help her mom. I just really like the dynamic, and I love the mysteries that are always kind of hidden within Taylor Jenkins Reid's books. They're always kind of entwined with each other, so it's just such a fun read. I also read Carrie Soto Is Back, which has a character that is related to these siblings, or there's some sort of something in there. So it's just so intriguing, so amazing. And this book is one that I highly recommend. Also, you don't have to read any of her other books to kind of follow the story. They're just kind of intertwined, but it's just very subtle, and it's just fantastic. So the next book in my list is Belladonna, and this book is by Adeline Grace. And I just enjoy this book so much from beginning to end. It was just beautiful. I mean, the cover is beautiful. And so on this book, we are following Sigma, who is kind of like this, I don't know if she's not a witch, but she has these powers. And so she can see death, and she can talk to death himself. She also has some magical powers as well, in terms of like she can heal herself, like nothing can really harm her. And she learned about this Belladonna berries, and so they're super poisonous. But she realized that she could overcome that. She will not die by eating the belladonna. And she goes to live with one of her family relatives, I think it's her uncle. And as she finds out that the wife that recently passed away was actually poisoned, and the daughter that now is sick is also being poisoned. So she has to kind of discover who's trying to harm them and what is happening. And I also really loved the love story on this book. It was just everything for me. So the next book in my list is The Daughter of Dr. Monroe, and this book is by Silvia Moreno Garcia. This is probably my favorite cover of them all. And so on this book, we are following Dr. Monroe, and he kind of created these hybrid beings by mixing different animals, and so he was known for that. And he had this beautiful daughter, and so this other man, I don't remember what his position was, but he was a very important man in society, wanted to marry her. Her father passes away, and she kind of is going through her things, and she discovers some secrets that he had. And also this man that wanted to marry her is kind of like using all of his power against her to basically give her no choice but to be with him. I really like the mystery behind that, but also all the representations of abuse of power, a lot of social inequality, and just some dark, sinister things that are happening on this town as well. So yeah, highly enjoy it and highly recommend. The next book in my list is Kristin Hannah's The Great Alone, and this is an old book. I had it on my stash for a long time, and I finally was able to read it because last year my favorite book of the year was The Four Winds, and I definitely wanted to read more by Kristin Hannah, and this book definitely did not disappoint. And oh my goodness, it just touched my heart so many times, and it made me cry. This is another book that I read at the beginning of the year that you're still kind of thinking about it. It just stays with you. So we're following this family. So basically the parents got together in high school, and the father goes to war, and the woman was left pregnant. So they kind of get married really quick, and she was always waiting for him. When the war was over and he came back, they continue being together, but he had already changed. He had so much trauma from what had happened to him, from the things that he had seen. And the wife was always so understanding, but he was very abusive to her and to the daughter as well. And then so here's the dilemma where the mom kind of has to decide if she's gonna support him or if she's just going to basically stand up for her daughter. And it was just beautiful from beginning to end. The next book in my list is All the Light We Can Now See by Anthony Doerr, and another book that made me cry and made me just have a different view in life in general. So on this book, we have a combination of historical fiction and fantasy as well. So we're following two different stories of children growing up during World War II. So one is this little girl who is the daughter of this man who works on this national museum. And the father, before they escape, he picked all these beautiful stones. And the magic of the stone says that it will protect you, right? So whoever owns the stone is going to be protected, but the curse of the stone is like whoever is around you or your loved ones are kind of going to have some sort of tragedy. And so the father decided to take one of these stones and give it to his daughter for protection. And then we're also following the story of this little boy in Germany. He is basically, I think he's an orphan, and he has a little sister or brother, but he kind of reached that age, which is really young, 12 or 13, where they're put to work on these mines. And you will see that besides all the difficulties that they had put into, they always have this beautiful hope in life. And it was just such a beautiful message, such an eye-opener as well, and I just love this book. So the next book in my list is The Girl with the Louding Voice, and this is by Abby Daré. And this book was just, again, another one that just gives you another view in life and just brings you a lot of strength. And I just love books that have that sort of like humanitarian message. And this book, we're following this little girl growing up in Nigeria, and so they're really poor, and her mom always taught her that education was the best thing that she could ever do and something that she always needed to do to be able to stand up for herself. However, the mother passes away when she's still really little, and the father is making her marry this man because the father could no longer afford having her. And also, by marrying this man, the father was going to kind of receive food so he can feed his other male children. And it was really sad. So then she goes to live with this man, and it's just the things that you see are very sad, but at the same time you do find a lot of hope on this book. And it was just beautiful because she never loses that willingness to be better, to study, to kind of stand up for herself. So I just absolutely love the book. I will probably read this again 1,000 times because it was just so incredibly touching, amazing. And so it also makes you realize that these are things that are happening today in this world. Like, sometimes we think about this type of situations happening like years ago, but no, this is actually something that happens now. It just definitely motivates you to want to kind of change the world, do something about it, and to follow your dreams. It's just such a beautiful book, an example of strength and resilience. Another book in my list is Piranesi by Susanna Clarke, and this book was pure magic. And so on this book, we're following Piranesi, who is basically lost in this labyrinth, that is supposed to be this gigantic house. And in this house, there is an ocean, there are different statues, and it just really transports you to this magical place. You're probably gonna be a little bit confused because it's really hard to know what is happening, especially because the main character himself doesn't know what is happening. But once you discover it, it's just top notch. I absolutely loved it. I love the desire to look for knowledge and also to realize where you want to be in life. I really love the message. I love the magic hidden in this little world, and I just really learned something very valuable from this book, and I loved it. This book on my list is Where the Crawdads Sing by Delia Owens, and I just absolutely love this book. On this book, we are following the story of Kaya, and she lives with her family on the marsh of North Carolina, and her father is very abusive. And so her mom basically leaves the family and leaves Kaya with her siblings and her alcoholic father. And then the brothers or the siblings kind of start to all leave when they reach an age where they can finally leave the house, because again, the father was very abusive. And so Kaya stays behind, and she basically raises herself. And then one day her father is just gone, and he is not coming back. And so she was really young, and she decides to kind of continue doing what her father was doing with the whole like fishing on the marsh and selling that. And it's just so unfair, all the things that she had to go through. And when she wanted to like go to school, all the kids will make fun of her because she was obviously always really dirty and she didn't wear any shoes. When she was older, she was accused of killing one of the most popular like football players on the school, on this town, and the whole town was against her. And she basically had to fight for herself and prove her innocence. And I remember having so many beautiful quotes from this book. So it also makes you think about abandonment, the trauma that comes with that, and you know, kind, how do you find strength to move from there. So I love the messages on this book. I also watched the movie, which I absolutely loved, but I highly recommend reading the book first so you can kind of know all the little details that the movie is kind of missing. And so yeah, so those are all the books that I highly enjoyed on 2022. Let me know if you guys have read any of these books or which was your favorite book for 2022. I'm gonna be back with the 23 books that I want to read for 2023, and I will see you guys on the next one. Bye bye.